morning, friends. Today we are going to see the next point from the topic mechanical properties of fluids, that is the surface tension inside the capillary tube. Friends, we are going to see some competitive questions. Remember, I am going to explain you point by point, but we are taking the limited questions. You should try to solve more and more questions regarding by first you have to study that point, and based on that you should try to solve more and more questions. Then your confidence level will increase and you will be clear with that concept. Okay, now we will start with the first question. So before starting that, when we are studying about the theoretical part, the formula for the surface tension inside the capillary tube is T is equal to H R rho g upon 2 cos theta. That thing should be very clear here. Now based on that, we will see some questions. If the capillary tube having a height H is taken to the gravity free space, the liquid will be option A remains unchanged, option B decreases, option C increases and return, option D continues to rise. Friends, the water surface which will be present in, on the surface will be stored due to the gravitational force. So if the gravitational force will not be there, and if we have taken the gravity free surface, then inside the tube it will be rise continuously. So option number D will be correct. So in the gravity free space, the liquid level will continues to rise. That is the correct answer. Now we'll move to the second question. Second question is, a capillary tube of uniform bore is dipped vertically in water, rises by 7 cm. Then the radius of capillary tube will be, we have to calculate the radius. If ST with surface tension is given 79 per centimeter, acceleration due to gravity 1000 cm per second square, theta 0 degree, rho 1 gram per cc, the density of water is given here. Okay, so what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the radius. Friends, remember here all the units are in the CGS format. So if they are in the CGS format, not necessary to convert it into the SI. If one is in the SI, one is in the CGS, then we should try to bring into the same unit. So already all are in terms of the CGS, so we have to keep as it is. Okay, now based on the unit information, you can observe that the H height is given. Height, how much is the height? 7 cm. Then radius. Radius of the capillary tube will be, means radius you have to calculate. Again, ST, surface tension is given. Surface tension is T is equal to 70 dyne per centimeter. Then G, 1000 centimeter per second square. Theta 0 and rho density 1 gram per cc. So we have to calculate the radius. So we have to use the formula T is equal to H R rho g upon 2 cos theta. Now in order to calculate the radius, the formula will become R is equal to 2t cos theta. R is equal to 2t cos theta upon H rho g. H rho g. You know R is equal to 2. What is the value of T? 70. Cos of 0, 1. 2. Then here H, what is the value of H? 7. Rho is given as a value of 1. And there is 1000. So 7 ones are, 7 tens are, the 0, 0 will be also get cancelled, so we are getting the 2 upon 100. So 2 into 10 is 2 minus 2 centimeter. But if you observe the option, here 2 centimeter is there and 0.2 centimeter is there. But it is a 2 into 10 is 2 minus 2 centimeter. Now you will observe that here some units are given from the mm, so we can convert in terms of mm. So 2 into 10 is to minus 2 cm is nothing but the here 0.2 mm. So 0.2 mm is option number A is correct. Friends, here in terms of centimeter, we have got 2 × 10⁻²⁰ cm. But in the option, centimeter options are not correct, then we will go for the mm. And we know that 1 mm is equal to 10⁻²⁰ cm. Based on that, we have to convert the centimeter into the mm, and finally the answer is 0.2 mm. So here you should know that 1 mm is equal to 10⁻²⁰ cm. So centimeter we are converting into the mm, then we have to divide with the 10. So here when we are dividing with the 10, it will become the 2 × 10⁻¹, that is 0.2 mm. So that is option number A is the correct. Now I move to the third question. The third question is, water rises to a height of 2 cm in a capillary tube. If the diameter is 2/3, the water will rise to a height of 6 cm, 3 cm, 2 × 3 cm, 3 × 2 cm. Okay, so as per the question, so first height is given. How much is the height? 2 cm. If the diameter of the tube, friends, remember the diameter and the radius, they are in the direction proportional to each other. So the diameter is made 2/3 of the water. In the second diameter of the tube, it is equal to 2/3 of first diameter. So we can write in from this that R2 is equal to 2/3 R1. Okay. So here height is your second height we have to calculate. We know the formula for surface tension, T is equal to H R rho G upon 2 cos theta. If you observe the relation between the H and R, so remaining all are the constants, so we can write that HR is equal to constant. So based on that, we can take the formula H1 R1 is equal to H2 R2. Okay, so what is the value of H1? 2 cm. R1, we should keep as it is. H2, we have to calculate. What is the value of R2? 2/3 of R1. So R1, R1 will get cancelled here. R1 will get cancelled there. 2 will also get cancelled there. So we are getting the final answer. H2 is equal to 3 cm. H2 is equal to 3 cm. Means option number 2nd will be the correct. Friends, here we have considered the relation between H and R, and HR is equal to constant, and based on that we have calculated the third question. So I hope here you have understood this question. We have completed the third question here. Okay friends, now we will start the fourth question. Question number 4 says, which of the following graph represents the relation between the capillary rise and the bore of radius R? So we know the formula that T is equal to H R rho G upon 2 cos theta. Based on that we can say that the H R is equal to constant and H is inversely proportional to the R. Means if one quantity increases, other will decreases. So if we observe that here increases, this increases, option number C is not correct. Option D will be also not correct. So from option A and B, we have to choose the correct option, because one is increasing, other is decreasing. Remember, in the capillary tube, the rise is not very sharp. It will take some time. So option number A is correct. So here we can observe that as the radius is increasing, then the height will decrease, or if the height is increasing, then the radius should be decreasing. So option number A is correct. Remember, option A and B, both will look as similar, but as the rise is not sharp, then we have to choose the most appropriate answer. Suppose if instead of this graph, if another graph is given, suppose the graph will be given in this way, then option number B will be the correct, because all these are mismatched and this will be the correct representation of the decreasing order. So friends, remember, as per the question, we have to choose the most appropriate answer. Okay, so this is the regarding the question number 4. So H is inversely proportional to R and R is not sharp, so based on that option number A is correct. Now U shaped fin of a liquid formed between a wire frame and movable wire 5 cm long. Then the force required to hold the wire in the equilibrium is, in brackets, surface tension is equal to 0.024 Newton per meter. Option A, 2.4 Newton is minus 3 Newton. Option B, here we can write the 24 into 10 raised to minus 3, here Newton, 2.4 into 10 raised to minus 3 line, 24 into 10 raised to minus 3 line. So these are the options here. Friends, here if you observe, here what we have to calculate, we have to calculate the force. So we cannot use the formula T is equal to HR rho g upon 2 cos theta. Instead of that, we have another formula T is equal to F upon 2 L. This formula we have to use as usual from mileage here. So F is equal to T into 2L. F is equal to T multiplied by 2L. And the force is asked here. And the surface tension is given. So how much is the surface tension here? 0.0242. And how much is the length? Length is 5 cm. Now centimeter we have to convert in terms of the meter. So 5 into 10 into minus 2. So we have to do the multiplication here. F is equal to 5 to the 10. So 0.024 into 10 into 10 raised to minus 2. So further it will become 0.024 into 10 raised to minus 1. Now if we shift the decimal point after the 2 digit, 1, 2. So I am getting as a 2.4 into 10 raised to minus 3 Newton. So 2.4 into 10 raised to minus 3 Newton is option number A will be correct here. So friends, remember here, as per the question, T is equal to F upon 2L, length is given. So only here the length, two surfaces are in the contact. So we have to use a factor 2, which we have studied in the previous lecture. So this formula we have to use here. Next question, we move to the next question. This is the question number 6. Question number 6 says, if a capillary tube is tilted at 45 degrees and 60 degrees from the vertical, the ratio of the length L1 and L2 will be. So we know the formula for the surface tension, T is equal to HR rho g upon 2 cos theta. And if we are considering the height and the angle, then we can say that the height and the angle, they are just like this. L1 upon cos theta 1 is equal to L2 upon cos theta 2. And if we, the ratio of the length will be asked here, so the formula we have to modify. L1 upon L2 is equal to, if we do the cross multiplication here, then we can get the L1 upon L2 is equal to cos theta 1 upon cos theta 2. Cos of theta 1 upon cos of theta 2. What is the value of cos of theta 1? So if we observe the first angle, and it is a 45 degree, so cos of 45, 1 upon root 2, and cos of theta 2. Cos of theta 2 is a cos of 60, it has value as a half. Now if we go to the numerator, it becomes 1 upon root 2 multiplied by 2 by 1. If we divide here, we are getting the root 2 by 1. So root 2 by 1, that is a correct answer. So friends, here we have completed the 6th question. So I hope you have understood this question. Make the notes properly. Thank you. Have a nice day.